just heard in the version given by St. Mark, which is, of course, the way in which St. Peter, especially at Rome, presented this wonderful, simple, profound explanation of our human history. I say it touches not only the chosen people of old, it touches all the rest of the nations, especially represented by that great empire that once flourished, known as the Roman Empire, where St. Peter preached just this. Who is the maker of this world, and how did he make it, and why did he make it? It is the Heavenly Father. He made the world because he loved us, above all because he loved his dearly beloved Son who would become one of us. That is why he made the world. That is why he made this wonderful vineyard. Vineyard is a wonderful place to live and work, especially if it is the vineyard of the Lord. And those who were privileged, especially the chosen people, but ultimately, all of us who are members of the family of Adam, that means the human family. Human is simply the Roman word for being made from the earth in a special way. Adam, from the earth. So you could say, if you don't like to use the word man or the word human, you can use the word Adamite. And you will be fully in accord with that noble Hebrew language. Instead of doing the Lord's will. Underscore that. Doing the Lord's will. We are taught to pray, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. I come to do your will, not my own, to pray to our Lord, conversing with his Heavenly Father in the garden of Gethsemane. Adam and Eve, unfortunately, thought the other way, and that is where the trouble begins. Do your own thing. Being religious, being pious, being sacrificial like the Son of God, what has that got to do with existence? Get rid of all of that. Get rid of God himself, not just his servants, and you will be equal to God. Nothing much has changed since the garden known as Eden. Cease to be our place of residence in this life. Every temptation, every sin, what Agatha Christie's famous Aunt Jane used to call wicked, when she wanted to stigmatize some particular horrendous crime. The most wicked thing we can do is to deliberately refuse the honor, the service, the love that is due our God. So they said, when the heir, he made this world, remember, for his beloved Son, who is to become one of us, and therefore we are co-heirs with Christ, St. Paul says. Here is the heir. The Father, they will surely accept him. Instead they said, let us kill him. And our Lord pointed out, and this is what they will tell each one of us who prefers to serve the Lord, to work faithfully in his vineyard at whatever task he has assigned to us. We have an example of this in the wonderful life of the philosopher St. Justin. Second century, let's say circa the year 150 of the Christian era. Why was he put to death? Because he wouldn't deny the wisdom of the cross, St. Paul's term for true philosophy. And he said to Rusticus, that's a curious name for a prefect, but it was the man's name, roughly translated into English, Rusticus means country bumpkin. Can you imagine calling the head of the FBI or the KGB or the SS country bumpkin, you country bumpkin, why are you addressing me in this way? You wouldn't last very long. Anyway, Rustica said, what really are you all about? You're engaging in this strange worship. You don't worship the emperor. No, why should I descend to fool tomfoolery when I have the truth? What is the guarantee? St. Justin knew the backing that he had. He wished that all would. He's called one of the earliest Christian philosophers. We don't have all his works, but the dialogue with Trypho the Jew and his Apologia, in the sense of St. Peter, once again, what is apologetics? It is not simply defensiveness, as the modern world would present it. It is a very persuasive presentation of all the reasons for our hope in preferring always God's will to the contrary will of some mere creature, and a recognition that it is radically stupid to prefer false worship, the idolatry that is so common every place in lands that were once Christian, that's to prefer being nothing, being non-existent rather than existing, to be dead rather than alive, to be cursed rather than blessed. And why can we be so sure in giving an account of the hope that is in us? Because the hope is absolutely guaranteed. Can anyone get away with rejecting God, taking over what belongs to him? No. What do you think he will come do? He will throw these wicked servants out and give the vineyard over to those he knows. Who are the ones he knows to be faithful? Those who love Jesus, who are willing to be martyrs, as he was a martyr. The great witness that he gave under Pontius Pilate, representative of the Roman emperor who said, I am God. What did he mean? The Roman emperors didn't have any clear idea of metaphysics or theology. All they meant was, I'm boss. It doesn't matter what God says. And if you don't like it, you know what's going to happen to you. Yes, I know what's going to happen, but that's not the last word. As neither Annas, Caiaphas, or Pilate had the last word, Jesus has the last word. And those who are one with him are those who indeed do what he told every beloved disciple to do, which St. Justin did. He's one of the great exponents of that wonderful theory of recirculation, a recapitulation that passes through Mary and Jesus in order to keep us forever in the paradise that has been prepared for Jesus and all those whom the Father has given to him. Let us ask always Our Lady, as did St. Justin, that she will indeed help us to be faithful, to always recognize the difference between truth and falsehood, truth and the big lie, truth and the big deception, seduction, the difference between genuine goodness, God himself, and what is only a seductive, false, pseudo imitation. The Christ, not the Antichrist. The Church, not the Antichurch. The woman who crushes the head of the serpent, and we too will know that blessedness not 10, not 50, not 100 years from now after we have passed. We will know it here in just a few moments, when we join our Lord in his sacrifice. No matter how humble we are, we will, as it were, be able to taste the blessings, the eternal blessings, that is what it means to eat of his flesh and drink of his blood. Though you die, you will live, and I will raise you up on the last day. Praise be Jesus and Mary.